Lovely spam, wonderful spam, wonderful spam, wonderful spam, spam, spam.
To the few people unfamiliar with it, Spam is a salty canned pork product made by the Hormel Food Corporation. It was introduced in 1937 and initially created to take advantage of the low price of pork shoulder, which didn't sell well at the time. Obviously, this was before pulled pork. Hormel has never been entirely forthcoming about the name, though some theorize that it is a contraction of spiced ham, although it doesn't contain any conventional spices, or an acronym for shoulder of pork and ham. During World War II, it became part of the American GI's diet and was referred to as ham that couldn't pass its physical, meatloaf without basic training, and the special army meat. The military bought 75 tons of Spam during the war, valuing it as a cheap, easy-to-keep source of protein and fat. With food rationing and areas of famine during the war, Spam became an appreciated commodity. Russians valued cans of the pink pork that had been part of the Allied package. In the Pacific Theater, Spam was so valued that it became a crucial part of the cuisines of Okinawa, Guam, the Philippines, and Hawaii. Spam continues to be widely consumed and appreciated. However, it does have a reputation in some areas for being a poverty food, or is rejected because it's perceived as highly processed, high in sodium, and high in fat. Spam does, however, have a pretty simple ingredient list of pork shoulder, ham, salt, water, modified potato starch to keep it all together, sugar, and sodium nitrate, which is a preservative. Now take about 2 pounds of pork shoulder. Doesn't have to be super accurate, and you don't necessarily have to use a pork butt or pork shoulder. You could use, any other type of pork. Probably want to have it fairly fatty, though, so I probably wouldn't go with lean stuff like pork chops or anything like that. And you want to go ahead and cut these up into cubes about this big. So, and be sure and get the fat, because unfortunately to make this Spam, you're going to have that fat. You can tell everybody's going, boy, that really looks good. Okay, so what we're going to do here, start with about a pound of ham, and go ahead and cut that into cubes. Okay, for seasoning, I'm going to add a tablespoon of salt, and I go ahead and put this in on the meat. Before I do it, a tablespoon of sugar, and we can adjust this after we grind it too. A tablespoon of cornstarch, and a tablespoon of, there we go, Morton Tender Quick. Make it a heaping tablespoon. Now we lay things out on a tray, and we're going to put it in the freezer for half an hour.
20 minutes later.
Okay, go through it, and we're just going to start grinding it down.
Lovely spam, wonderful spam, lovely spam, wonderful spam, spam, spam.
Later.
Okay, after several hours of freezing and refreezing and sharpening the grinder, I've finally got pork all over my kitchen, and I've kind of made this meat mushroom here, but at least I've got it grounded. This better be some darn good Spam. Okay, now we're going to just stir this all up. I've been stirring it quite a bit here beforehand. I also added a little water as it was kind of stiff. And then we're going to put it into a loaf pan. So I got to get all this into this little loaf pan here. Let's see if that fits. Yep. Okay. And I keep everything really fridged down here. Keep it cold. So there's my shallow water bath just to see what it looks like. That's going to go into a 250-degree oven for 3 hours.
3 hours later.
Okay, my Spam loaf is at 155 degrees out of the oven. There it is. We're going to take a brick wrapped in foil. I cleaned it first, and we're going to put the brick on it, and we're going to let that cool overnight in the refrigerator.
Tomorrow.
Okay, let's see how it's been. It's been in the fridge overnight, and we are going to just dump it out here on this foil. That doesn't work, so let's just take a knife and... There, that's probably why. It is really stuck in there with that grease, the fat. This actually looks pretty good. It, like I say, it looks more like sausage than... Like, it looks like salami. That's, I was just thinking, I should have added a lot of pepper to it or and garlic. That would have been good. But again, that would have probably ended up being salami. Okay. Hopefully we can overcook. And it's not coming out, so we're going to run some hot water. Okay, let's try it again here. Hey, there it came out. And there's our... Oh, it's even got the little jelly stuff there. Look at that. Can you see all... I hope you can see. Let's slice it off. Ooh, Spam. Look at that. That looks actually pretty good. Let's get a nice slice here. And this stuff can be frozen, so. Okay, let's cook up this piece. Actually, the butt end looks really good, but I'm gonna go ahead and cook. Well, it looks nice and oily like Spam does, but oily, I say that just fat. This piece is kind of rough looking, but I bet it tastes fine. I'm trying to brown it. It doesn't seem to brown like the Spam that you get in the can does. I think this probably has a little less sugar, which does causes that effect. I'm hungry, and that looks good, so let's go ahead and give it a try. Here we go. Let you get a good look at that. And let's taste it and see how it tastes. It's a little spongier. That's really good. It tastes pretty much like regular Spam does, but it's maybe not quite as greasy and it's not quite as salty, so definitely an improvement. Anyway, this experiment, a lot of work going into this. I don't know if I'd ever do this again, but it's an interesting experiment, and I think it turned out pretty well. Okay, that's what I got.